turn into 14, which is the 14th letter, which is the letter N. 11. Oh, what? Then you begin to emanate again to 1,000. And then you enter into 14. Then you begin to realize you are 11. Oh, are you now 11? Who was in the upside down world? Who didn't have a mother or a father? A bitten apple, an embryo. Jesus didn't have a father. Harry Potter didn't have a mother or father. Dorothy Gale didn't have a mother or father. Luke Skywalker didn't have a mother, but he had a robot father. It's a matrix. So you have a twin, and you'll realize that once you get with your twin and you become 11 and all that. And so this is the table of truth that emanates and grows you to not a microcosmic level, but a macrocosmic level. And it becomes a stadium. And sometimes it's the number 6, and then it goes to the number 9. Then it goes to the number 6 again, and then it goes to the number 9. And so when you are going around this emanation, you're going to get into math. You're going to get into science. You're going to get into the elements. You're going to become a master of Plato and Socrates and get into the Platonic solids. You're going to enter into the master room or table of Solomon. The table of Solomon or the hall of Solomon is numerical, and it represents a story that had to emanate as power over time. So my darling, if you don't feel powerful, if you are here or here, then what are you waiting for? You have great things ahead of you. And if the Queen of Sheba is your higher self, stand back, people. Stand back. This is God and the emanation of God. And we are all mirrors of that one emanation. And there is no other God but this one. We are all reflections of it. Fractals, even. Remember on the Queen of Hearts when the Mad Hatter lost his hat? And then who took the hat? Cheshire Cat. And what is the Cheshire Cat? A place. What is that place called? Hecate. The three-faced goddess? Mm-hmm. You get into that world, you'll realize that there's truths that come from different bodies of quote-unquote gods. They're not really gods. They're just, you're down here and you consider this person a god. Then you get here and you're like, oh, that's a god. And then you get here and you're like, oh, no, this is a god. And you get up here and you're like, nothing matters. Nothing matters. Oh, my gosh. You know, and so there's, I am everyone and everything and nothing at the same time. Oh gosh, then it gets really boring. Then you might purposely fall just to become dumb again. It's fine. But yeah, that's how it works. Take a picture. Yeah, so if you're a tarot reader and you get into these tables, if it's a square table, it represents a prison, a labyrinth, somebody who is in a prison or a labyrinth. So when you look at the rectangle Last Supper table, it represents that they're leaving the table of pain and suffering. It's the Last Supper. But when the tables turn into a circle, this represents power. So behind every pleasure and every pain is a sacred geometrical shape. Some shapes represent pain. Some shapes represent power or pleasure. And when you get to know which one is which, then you begin to start thinking thought forms of God. You might, before you go into Walmart, put a dodecahedron around your body or a fire tetrahedron around your body in order to protect your energy and your biofield. And so when you begin to have thought forms of God, then you become a master, right? And you begin to become a master of tables and time and all kinds of stuff. But you do have to become a scientist, unfortunately. Because then you're like, really? I have to study more? Well, can't I just make gardens? Talk to... Yeah, if you want to be in Hufflepuff, you can go and make a garden, talk to the trees, talk to the roots, get into apothecary, talk to the ancient wisdom of the earth, heal the earth, take all your crystals that you have, on your shelves, on your by your bed, and go put them outside. They don't belong to you. Give it back to the earth. It needs that energy. Go put it outside for a week or so. Let them get activated. Let the earth feel the energy of its long lost beloved stone. And then bring it back in your house if you want to, but talk to the earth, talk to the trees, and let the science of the invisible ones give you dreams and ideas. And then you become like a healer, and then you become like an apothecary, medicine woman. But then when you're in like Ravenclaw or Gryffindor or Slytherin, then your job moves you in different ways. Your truths and the different tables that you enter are like the four schools. One school represents earth, one represents water, one represents air, one represents fire, and each has its own mastery. Name, and I will read for you. Donations are appreciated. I give you a big kiss. Mwah, thank you. Because they go toward everyone's reading, not yours. I may read for you if you donate, but it's about your higher self telling you to donate, because I may go back to charging for these readings. For now, they're free. So if you have extra money, donate. It goes toward these readings. And I feel to just do donations at this time. And that's just, you know, sending stickers and stuff like that. So you just, you guys, thank you so much for the roses. Thank you for the gifts. Somebody that I'm about to read for, I just have the card. And the other card is here. Somebody has death and judgment. And don't think this is bad, first of all. It means that you're going through the final release of all the suffering. Judgment, the release of the gods of judgment, of judgment. You're going to be released from it. It's done. The gods of suffering, the gods of judgment is just done. We're just done with it, you know. So this is what is being brought forward. Let's see who this goes to. So Emmy, I just, oneness, one love, I just followed you. I requested to follow you. Hello, congratulations. All of these readings are for you guys, by the way. Emmy's reading will help you. Your higher self is ready to love you and show you what real love is, what real joy is. And Emmy, your higher self is ready for you to step into magic. Are you ready to step into magic? No more judgment, no more suffering, no more. Thank you, Spirit, for being all-knowing, all-loving, and all-kind. sweet, wonderful you. You make me happy with the things you do. Love you so. This feeling follows me wherever I go. I never did believe in miracles, but I've a feeling it's time to try. I never did believe. So, you signed an allegiance to a written word, and this Santa, took your animal to fly their sleigh. So you are a slain one. You were a sleigh. You're a soldier, a soul dyer. This is the Statue of Liberty over here, where the gods take your life force to use for their chariot, and you pledge allegiance to that word, and you and children get put into boxes. This is the labyrinth. So, Emmy, that's not okay with me. If you want to get your animal back and not give your animal away to what supposedly a kind thing, then what we're going to do is we're going to take evil and turn it into good. All right. So the labyrinth is called the Olympic Hunger Games. You have three rings of power, and your third ring, which is an animal, the golden compass is true. The Hunger Games is true. It means that we were put into a labyrinth and in a box. And the box is it's the story of Dorothy, and you walk the spiral, and they sacrifice 7 girls and 7 boys, the 14 pieces of Osiris's body, your twin, and they take your twin, and they take your animal, and they do things. And so what they do with your animal, which is immortal, is like Voldemort eating the unicorn, or they would always slay, the sleigh of Santa, a white bull, a white unicorn, or a white holy dove. So it is something that is cut from us, and some people do it willingly, and it's almost as if you're doing it willingly, and there's a book on your head. There's like cards or something on your head, like contracts or something. And what I want to know is why, and what can we do, and if it's something that we can, if I can actually change for you, or if it's something that I can help you awaken to, or what it is that's keeping you. So notice that the Santa doesn't have a hand over here, and he's holding a star that has points all over it like this, and it has a pointed star, and it's right behind this fire, and here's his hand right here. Zeus, his wife Hera, they have a labyrinth. It's called the Hunger Games. They put us in the labyrinth. It's a matrix. You can get out of the labyrinth if you can get to the 12th month. Cinderella at the 12th hour had to be home. Jesus left the Bible at 12. The 12th month is Christmas. You are a tree. You are stuck in a tree. So in Jewish mysticism, they say the unrepented are stuck in a tree. You know a person by the fruit of their tree, right? So this tree represents you. It's the tree of life. If at the 12th month, Christmas, you can awaken to truth out of this labyrinth where the Holy Spirit, the unwritten word, not the written word, dominates you, a tree or flesh, you will become illuminated with your robe of glory. If you, at Christmas, open the box of your gift of the Holy Spirit, then the box will open to a cross. This cross is that you will awaken to not water and earth, but you will awaken to fire and air. You will enter into the realm of the gods, where you will become a master of your biofield, of your mind, and of the labyrinth. But you have to be, this purification is an awakening to truth. So when the white snow falls at Christmas time, it represents purification. And so if you open your gift at Christmas time, and there's nothing in there but an empty box and a cross, that's good. It represents that you have learned to become nothing and yet everything, no one and yet everyone, and you have surrendered completely to the will of the true God, not the God of suffering, not the God who keeps coming around every Christmas lying to you. Yeah, there's Santa. Yeah, there's a reindeer. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. No. Statue of Liberty is S-O-L. It means the sun. And when we are in the eye of the sun, this is life. And the twin of the Statue of Liberty is also an eye, but it's an eye that fell. It's called the Eiffel Tower. In a pair of eyes. Two eyes. When you die, you will go to Paris. Put the word die in Paris. It's paradise. It's a two-tower system, high-tech cloning system of life and death, right? Until you find your Trinity. It's a third tower that takes you out of duality, which is your third ring of power. But we were in a matrix called a box, which put us as a bitten apple. We were an embryo that was cut, or we were a bitten apple from the tree of life. And so what was bitten from you was the sun. And what the gods take from you is the sun. Because you represent life and death. You are mortal. This means 6 protons and 6 neutrons. This means you are stuck in time. 12 hours, 12 months, 12 zodiac signs, district 12, where nothing is in your favor, or the age of Pisces. And so 6 protons and 6 neutrons decay and die. Only one thing lives forever, and that's what they want from you. L. Electrons. The sun flips its magnetic polarity every 11 years, right? And it is the immortal self. And this self is the holy dove. It is the one that is white, pure, and can fly. It is your animal. So when the dove descends upon your biofield, it turns into a triquetra. And this is a trinity. This is why your horse has 1, 2, 3 here. Your horse is talking to you. What is this jerk doing whipping me? If he's so powerful, what does he need me for? If he's so powerful, what does he need the animal for? Why doesn't he just fly himself? Why do these bearded gods always represent water? What are their big old noses and the mouths and their faces? What do they always represent? Water. They're underwater. Osiris was put in a box underwater, under the tree, under the table here. So when you have a floppy hat like that, it's somebody who doesn't have enough power to live forever until their hat goes straight up. Then you learn that you have to go through a divine marriage of water and fire in order to birth the child and the trinity. So if you're the one Neo who needs your trinity, you just follow that white rabbit right there, then your third ring of power is what the gods steal from you. And they put you in a labyrinth and they cut you. So Osiris's body was cut 7 and 7, and they sacrificed 7 boys and 7 girls. It is the Hunger Games. You're a human who had 14 pieces. The letter N is the 14th letter. You had a twin, 7 and 7. Zeus had a twin, Apocalypse. Inki has a twin. Everybody has a twin. But then when you take G away from N, they cut your twin off of you. So 14 minus 7 is 7. They cut you in the Hunger Games. E, R. R is 18, 666. They cut something from you. So the Hunger Games is about you being hungry for your original divine inheritance. And you were not born as a god. You were born in sin. The god of the moon was named Sin. All fallen angels are chained to a rock. The rock is the moon. But the moon is Sin. The god of the moon is named Sin. But we are here on the earth. We're not on the moon. It's 75% water. You're 75% water. This means that we have the ability to mirror the truth. Now we can mirror the moon, or we can mirror the sun. And when the sun descends upon your biofield invisibly, you go through a cosmic electricity that lifts you up and activates you out of the written word and into the unwritten word of the Holy Dove and the Holy Spirit. So you won't go to January 1, you will go to 13, not 12. And so this means that you are not tethered to time. It is a master that walks on water, a master of time. So let's see what Spirit does for you. Now that we see where you are, you're being taken for a ride in some way where I don't know where or how or why, but your higher self, your animal, I don't know why you're pledging allegiance to the Statue of Liberty there. You just need to be aware that you are on a microcosmic level and your body is just an avatar, and you're not going to sign a contract to anything here because you're not of this world. Your higher self is not of this world. You are of many worlds. So we don't care about these contracts. We don't care about politics or religions. I don't know why you're here. Maybe I didn't pick up on your energy. I don't know. All I know is whoever it was, and if it is you, and if it does vibe with you, we're going to try to change this today. I'm guessing that you probably need a new name. You're going to refer to your physical body as an avatar. And then you're going to talk about your higher self and seek first the kingdom of God through that energy. So yeah, I'm just going to put a heart there. And so what I would like for the spirit guides, the guardian angels, the spirits of truth and life energy to take this person out of the grips of the ones who are using her animal. Powerlessness is a terrible thing. It will lead us to depression, anger, sick fixations and addictions, and illusions that aren't real. We need our holy dove back. We need our energy back. And if it's up to you and if it's okay for you, we would like to give this person their power back, if even a little bit. And remove this allegiance, these contracts. Yeah. I see that it's just a matter of time is what I'm hearing. So I'm going to just see what they're going to say to you and about how to get out of there and what's going to go on. So believe that. Okay, I see what's happening to you now. All right, so here is a divine true marriage. For some reason, they have you marrying something that's not your twin. So they stick something on you that's not your twin, and then they take your animal and they give you a false animal or they give you a false twin. So here is a divine marriage of flesh, you being flesh. You are considered male. You are considered flesh. All right, spiritually speaking. And this is who your twin is. This is, and so for, you still have this allegiance here. You still have pledge allegiance hand. Anyway, but the divine feminine is standing here holding flowers saying, this is the marriage of your twins. You and your twin. Awakening. This is you're better, but you're still pledging allegiance for some reason. I don't know why. You're entering into a hall that looks like a heart a little bit, but it is Emerald City. It is M. If I were you, I would find some way to sign another contract. Oh, so it's Dagon the Fish God. Somehow we sign contracts to this god. I've seen him a million times. It's something that goes like this. I don't know if you have people who practice Catholicism, but they worship Dagon. So there's a ring of power here. It's a divine marriage of flesh and spirit. Okay, so I'm seeing pictures of Bastion from the Neverending Story coming forward, riding on Valcor. Good luck, dragon. Okay, so things are shifting for you. It looks like what happened for you, my darling, is your Artex went into the swamp of sadness. So you lost your animal, and it went into the swamp of sadness. So you had to have a good luck dragon. It's a replacement to something that you lost. So it went into the swamp of sadness, which is apparently America or something here with the Statue of Liberty. And so it went into the swamp of sadness, and so now you need a good luck dragon. And this good luck dragon is going to take you to give yourself a new name. So what Bastion yelled out was Moonchild when he gave himself a new name. And you give yourself a new name, you rebirth yourself, you have a grain of sand, and you create a new world, a new reality from that grain of sand through this awakening. So you're being given a good luck dragon. Yeah, you have a nun on you. That's, I don't know where you got the nun, but it's definitely a black nun with her hands behind her back. Somebody false here. So that was cut, and now you have Valcor, which is your good luck dragon, and from there you close your eyes in the flesh and you pledge allegiance to your higher self, not to anything else. But you did have Dagon the Fish God on you. So let me show you Dagon the Fish God if you don't know who he was. Dagon the Fish God ate the phallus of Osiris. Osiris was put into a box underwater. It's the labyrinth. Dagon's son is Baal, the god of child sacrifice. These are gods of sacrifice, suffering, pain, death, right? And it was what you got. You got death and judgment, right? And it's not you, though. It was Dagon. Now, Dagon could be a good guy. I don't know. I never met him. So I could be polarized by the written word, too. But I'll show you what... See, when you're talking about Dagon the Fish God, you go back to Mithra. Mithra cut the white bull, sacrificed the white bull, and the white bull turned into the moon, right? You always see Dagon the Fish God near Mithra. And whose hat looks like Mithra? The hat of Mithra. Santa. Do y'all know what Mithra looks like? Has that hat that looks like that? Let me show you. Let me show you Mithra. I'll find a very good picture. You can see their hat. All right, probably this one. You see that hat right there that looks like Santa? See him cutting the bull? You see Dagon the Fish God right there? The mermaid gods? Right there. Hold on. I'll find another one for you. Hold on. This one. See his floppy hat? That. Why would a white bull be sacrificed? Because it's your animal. Why would a holy dove be sacrificed? It's a white animal. It's your animal. It's the freaking golden compass, people. We were born not as gods. We were born ignorant. We were cut. So let me see if we could find a picture of Dagon near Mithra. Always near Mithra, the fish god. Not there. There's one where he's under a rainbow looking thing, stone. And right next to him is Dagon the fish god. I think it might be maybe this one. I'd have to look for it. Let me look real quick and see if I can see that rainbow one where he's underneath a rainbow on both sides, and it makes a curving line, and on each side is Dagon the Fish God. And what is the Olympic Games? The sacrifice of the white bull. The Minotaur. Put into the labyrinth, the bull, the horse, Artex, Swamp of Sadness. So, all right, I'm not finding it. Let's go ahead and look at Dagon the Fish God. Okay. So when you're looking at Dagon the Fish God, sometimes he's floating, sometimes he's walking, sometimes he looks like he's flying, but sometimes he looks pretty creepy, really scary. There are groups of people who dress like him. Show you. See? Or how about this one? Or how about this one? See any similarities? What does this goddess have? An animal. What is she drinking? Blood. What is this? A labyrinth. Mithra. Animal. You. Box. No hat going down. Seven backwards out of the seven sacrifices. Divine marriage. Allegiance not to Santa, to your higher self. Now, where's your horse? I see you have your good luck dragon. Oh yeah, your horse passed away. Or went into the swamp of sadness or was taken or something. But your good luck dragon over here says, once you get your third ring of power, once you step into the peacock, there's a peacock here. Once you step into this peacock and you go through the fire of rebirth, you bring your Artex back to life. That's what happened, was your Artex will come back to life. You just will see it here. And this Artex energy is your power. And you know, it's Horus. It's Isis, Osiris. But not yet. So if you're feeling in any way powerless, you'll start feeling better soon. You just had to have a good luck dragon. Our allegiance isn't to anything in the written word. It is to the Holy Spirit. Which is the unwritten word. Have you ever read a book? Oh, hello. I'm the voice of the Holy Spirit. I wrote a book. No? Yeah, the horse is tired of being sold. There's a song about this. And this guy who sings it, I believe he's a Jew. He's Jewish. And his name is Leonard Cohen. Leonardcohen. And I think the song is called Anthem. And in the song,
Actually, let's sing it together. We can sing it as karaoke. Hold on. Anthem. I have the words here. They know about the holy dove being cut and used by the gods. The birds, they sing at the break of day. Start again, I heard them say. Don't dwell on what has passed away, or what is yet to be. Yeah, the wolves, they will be fought again. The holy dove, she will be caught again. He actually says cut again. But oh, thank you. Look at this. This is beautiful. Thank you, Angel. Give me a kiss. Thank you, baby. I can't wait to talk to you. Oh. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, sure. All right. Look how pretty.
There's a crack. A crack in everything. That's how the light gets in.
Anyway, he talks about the holy dove will be cut again, bought and sold, and then bought again. The dove is never free. Not just the holy dove. Anything white. The white bull gets sent to the Minotaur Labyrinth.
We have to leave by like 5.
Is it almost 5?
I don't know. I don't have my phone on me.
Yep.
Four.
Oh, it's 4. Okay. All right. Bought and sold and bought again. Bought by whom? Sold by whom? Who's buying our animal? Why? Where? What? How? When? We don't know. I know. So, we could go around frolicking in the fields of flowers and being happy with this life, and that's fine. You're totally fine with that. However, you might be aware that something dreadfully was removed from you. Truth that you've been cut from. A peace and a love that surpasses all understanding was cut from you. And so whether or not it's a real animal, I don't know, but it's always a white unicorn, a white rabbit, a white holy dove, or a white minotaur bull that was sent to the freaking labyrinth where they sacrificed 7 girls and 7 boys because the 14 pieces of Osiris's body was cut, 7 for her and 7 for him. By who? Set. In a box. Santa. All right? And so when we wake up and realize, oh my gosh, maybe, you know, I don't, like, who's going to teach us? Who's going to show us how to get this back together again? Even the written word has been interpreted by liars. We know that. There's too many contradictions in that book. On one hand, the Apostle John says, if you hate your brother, you're a murderer. And then Jesus goes, if you don't hate your brother, your mother, your children, even your own life, you can't be my disciple. It's like, really? You really use the word hate there? Okay. And he called a woman a dog. So the battle of Ragnarok, the wolves, the dogs, the curse of Cain, the canine, versus the vampires. Jesus said, drink my blood and live forever. He did lay a reality for you in a box. Yes, he did. Yes, he made this matrix. Yes, he did. Yes, he made the Age of Pisces, because otherwise you would be in the abyss. He gave you his third ring of power in order to transcend it and get out. But there are tricks here. And every matrix has viruses. And every matrix if you go to the Egyptian written word, there's masters of the net, not learning to not get caught in this net. What is the net? The World Wide Web. It's a web that you can get caught in.
And so there are masters who teach you to not get caught in the net and to find a third ring of power through truth and growth, and then suddenly you become whole again. And then guess what? And then you step into a mastery. And so I could be wrong about this, but it's a repetitive pattern. And so you just needed a good luck dragon, darling. I'm not saying that Dagon the Fish God is a jerk or this nun is a jerk. I'm just saying that I don't understand why they're lying to us. If they're going to dress up like Dagon the Fish God, freaking tell us they worship Dagon the Fish God. Why lie? All right, there's something amiss, something awry afoot. And I will say I have seen things on the spirit realm, and I know for a fact that they're what they do. They take your higher self and they put themselves in their place. So they get to live forever, you get to suffer. And they see us as dogs. They see us as cretins. And that's what the bull is. Mm-hmm. Yeah, deprogramming the matrix is, it's not really about deprogramming the matrix. It's about just waking, that's all. It's just an awakening. I'm going to tell you the story so you don't hate Jesus and you don't hate Dagon the Fish God and you don't hate anybody. All right, I'm going to tell you how it works real quick, real fast. Like an embryo, you were cut. You were cut from your twin, 7 and 7. The reason you have to be born again is to awaken to your twin. Visible self, invisible self. Then you have an animal that represents immortality. This immortal self is like a unicorn or a holy dove. But it's more than this. It's 666. 6 protons and 6 neutrons decay and die. But what they cut from you is electrons. And the sun flips every 11 years. Jesus had 3 rings of power. He was immortal. He saw that those of us, like an embryo, who were a bitten apple, were cut. When you go to the Big Apple in New York City, they will tell you right to your face that they know that you about this two-tower system. You celebrate in the Big Apple the 4th of July that is 7-4. 11. The two towers that fell looks like the number 11. Fell on 9/11. That equals 11. It was in front of a body of water that looks like the number 11. Water and fire. 11, 11, 11, 11. And the sun flips every 11 years. And then you get to, how does this technology work? Well, when you are in a dual system, perpetuating life and death over and over again, somebody saw that we were like a ping pong ball, going boing, 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 back and forth, right? And never maintaining memory, never just going into a new body every time. Your consciousness goes into a new body. And it's not a bad thing. So for instance, let's say in one life we learned a lot. We learned a lot about ourselves, but we were pretty much ignorant and a jerk. And we pass away, and our consciousness goes into another body that in this life we begin to wake more, and our eyes are open, and we grow a little larger every time. And then we didn't maintain memory in this life because we haven't reached our twin. So your twin is immortal. So let's say your twin is a really tall soul. And in order to make a great crossing into the body of our twin, we have to match the frequency of our twin. So in this two-tower system, we haven't grown to the size of our twin yet. Maybe the next life you get another body that grows you even taller. And then taller and taller and taller and taller until one day you and your twin are the same size. And then guess what happens there? Then you're set free. You make something called the Great Crossing. And this great crossing is that you have become Christ. You have become Christ conscious. And you've become the master M that walks on water. You've met your twin. Then what happens? Then Mary and Joseph make Jesus. Then Isis Osiris makes Horus. Horus the horse, right? Which is what they sacrifice all the time. Jesus, God sacrificed his own son. The gods of child sacrifice. Well, so Jesus said, I laid the foundation for you. Meaning he is the matrix. He is the box. Yes, it's a jerk. I know. But it wasn't meant to always be a jerk. He made a false place system in order for you to be strong enough to be able to handle being a god when you get to the frequency and the adepthood and the living. So it's not always a jerk here, not always. But I will say that the gods love to, the big bad wolf eats the sun. When the wolves come around, they want to harvest you. They do. And you have to be careful. There are dark energies wanting to feed off of you. Yes. And you have to be aware of those traps. But the story of it is the Wizard of Oz. So Dorothy had to heal through shame, ignorance, and narcissism. Ignorance is the scarecrow. Narcissism is the tin man without a heart. Shame and blame is the lion. Put him up. I'll fight you with both hands behind my back. Once you get rid of those three lower chakras, you enter into the fourth chakra, which is green. It is called Emerald City. You can call it M. It's when you get to the top part of your biofield, or anti-M. Once you get to Emerald City, you're not a munchkin that's short of understanding anymore. You've entered into a mansion expansion, and you become tall. And then you fly like a pretty little bluebird over the seven colors of the rainbow because your frequency has matched your twin. So it's a process. Sometimes you do get cut, and it was a mistake that we all make when we fall and we don't know what we're doing. It's always ignorance that makes us fall. They know not what they do. They don't know what they're doing. So here you are, life after life, growing, growing, growing. Maybe your next life you go into the body of what becomes a wizard, or the next life you grow into a body of something else. Each life makes you taller and taller, until you finally get out of the two tower system, which is the matrix that was laid down for you by Jesus. He said, turn over a stone and there I am, cut a piece of wood and there I am. I laid the foundation for you. He is the age of Pisces. He is the two fish. But he says, follow the water bearer. The water bearer, the 11th house, Aquarius. Once you get to a certain adepthood, you're ready. And then you make the great crossing. And the great crossing is you are united with your eternal life, electrons, which sets the moon on fire, sets the earth on fire with a blue flame. And this blue flame makes everything L, electrons, 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 all immortal. So Jesus is the way. He's like a vampire. He's the one who lives forever. But the wolf, Fenrir, is always after your son. The battle of the gods is the battle of the gods of twilight. Ragnarok is called the battle of the gods of twilight. The wolves versus the vampires. The wolf wants to eat your son. The big bad wolf will blow down your three houses, little piggies. Or the big bad wolf wants the little red riding hood, or red apple. And so we don't fight principalities and powers, we fight flesh and blood. Be aware of your enemy is a wolf. The vampire wants you to become powerful so that you can do the will of God. That's all. So don't be mad at all the gods. Just be aware that we were cut as a bitten apple. Maybe we truly were miscarried. Maybe that's why all these stories of these kids not having any parents is something that just keeps perpetuating. Maybe we were miscarried. And our miscarried bodies went to a mirror world, 1111. And this mirror world was a jerk. Maybe. And then maybe it's like the movie Tangled. You're in a tower, Fiona, or the movie Tangled, and you have a stepmother, Cinderella, and they're jerks to you until you go through the divine marriage. and you go to a mansion, and then what happens? Then you realize who you are. Ah! And you get your power back. Oh, you were choked by your own cord. Oh my gosh. Oh, I'm so sorry both your parents died when you were young. I'm so sorry. Yeah. So don't be mad at the Matrix. The Matrix is here because otherwise you would be in the nothing, the abyss. You're here to learn and grow your embryo back to your divine body. You were cut from your twin, from your animal. This Trinity, you're the one, Neo, who needs your Trinity. You just follow the white rabbit. That is Triquetra, wisdom, power, and understanding. It's really about awakening to knowledge and understanding. So, the ring of power. Solomon had three rings of power. With the third ring, you can spin new worlds and new realities. Two rings, you're under the powers of the Matrix. It's just time to wake up, babies. Activate the heart of a child. Listen to comedy. Joy is your strength. Go outside. Make a garden. Connect with nature. Your heart chakra needs negative ions. Positive ions comes from bitten apples. Your cell phone. Cell towers. Computers. This all disrupts your power. Disrupts your energy. We want to blame it on anybody, anything. It's really, you need to drink water. You need to make sure your pH is balanced. You need to get away from positive ions. Go outside. Meditate. Breathe. Clean your house. Clean your car. Clean your relationships. Clean your beliefs. Clean your emotions. Clean your thoughts. Clean your diet. Your holy temple is holy. Make things holy and sacred, okay? And your good luck dragon is here to help you get away from the jerks. It needs to be Osiris, Isis, Horus. Horus is the horse, which is your eternal life element. All right. I got to go. My husband just came out of being at the dentist, and we've got some things to do suddenly. So I need to go ahead and go. But you guys, please, don't be tethered to my words. Hear the words of your own higher self. And you don't have to believe everything I say. It doesn't matter what I say. Nothing matters. The whole world is but a thought and a dream. What matters is that you are powerful. If you have no power, then you may not be doing the will of God. Only the path of the light and the will of God gives you power. And you don't want power because you want worship or because you have low self-worth. You want to step into the realm of power because you want to do the will of God, and you want to grow your embryo, and you want to remember, and you don't want to be a fool. And you don't want to do foolish things. That's all. Don't be mad at anybody. It's all going to be okay. Big hugs from me to you. Your allegiance isn't to this world or to politicians or religions. Our allegiance is to the Holy Spirit, which is an animal.